Today's lesson is about using coordinate geometry to represent and or solve problems, midpoint, length of a line segment, and Pythagorean theorem. It is Common Core 9 through 12 standard G.SRT.8. First, let's do an example with midpoint. So how do we find this midpoint of this line segment AB? Well, the midpoint is the point right in the middle of A and B. And in order to find that, well, we got to know where A and B are first. Well, A is at 1-6 and B is at 5-6. Now, these are our ordered pairs that we're going to use. So A, that 1-6, we'll call it the x1, the y1. And B, which is at 5-6, we'll call that our x2, y2. And midpoint, what you do is you add up the x's and divide by 2. And then you add up the y's and divide by 2. So if we add up the x's, well, that's 1 plus 5 divided by 2. Add up the y's, that's 6 plus 6 divided by 2. Well, if you simplify that, 1 plus 5 is 6 divided by 2, and 6 plus 6 is 12 divided by 2. But both of these numbers are divisible by 2. 6 divided by 2 is 3, and 12 divided by 2 is 6. So the midpoint of the line segment AB is at the point 3-6. Let's do one more example of midpoint. So here we've got another line segment that we've also called AB. Looks a little bit different though, but the midpoint is still the same thing. It is the point right in the middle of A and B. Well, where is it at? Well, first of all, we got to know where is A and where is B. Well, A is at the point 2-1 and B is at the point 6-3. So that's our x1, y1 and our x2, y2 because midpoint, add up the x's, divide by 2, comma, add up the y's and divide by 2. So if we do that for these ordered pairs, we would get 2 plus 6 divided by 2 and 1 plus 3 divided by 2. Well, 2 plus 6, that's 8, and 1 plus 3, that's 4. But both of these numbers are divisible by 2. So 8 divided by 2 is 4, and 4 divided by 2 is 2. So the midpoint of line segment AB is the point 4, 2. Now let's do the length of a line segment. Now, in order to do that, this is a distance. So we need to know the distance formula. Well, first, let's see where is A and where is B. How far is it from A to B? Well, A is at the point 1-6 and B is at the point 5-6. So this is our x1, y1, or x2, y2. So very similar to what we just did with midpoint. But now we've got to know the distance formula. And the distance formula is the square root of the difference of the x's squared plus the difference of the y squared. So if we use our values and just plug them in, we're going to get 5 minus 1 squared because that's our x values, and then 6 minus 6 squared, that's our y values. So 5 minus 1, that's what, 4, and then we've got to do 4 squared, and then 6 minus 6, that's 0, and we've got to do 0 squared. Well, 4 squared is 16, 0 squared is 0, and 16 plus 0 is square root of 16. And we can do the square root of 16. The square root of 16 is 4. So the distance from A to B is 4 units. Let's do another example of distance formula. So we want to find the length of the line segment AB. Well, to do this, again, we need to know where is A and where is B. Well, A is at the point 2-1 and B is at the point 6-3. So that's our x1, y1, that's A, and our x2, y2, that's B. So the distance formula, difference of the x's squared plus the difference of the y squared, and you take the square root of all of it. Well, if we plug our values into that distance formula, we're going to get 6 minus 2 squared plus 3 minus 1 squared. Well, 6 minus 2, that's 4, and 3 minus 1, well, that's 2. So we've got to do 4 squared, which is 16, and 2 squared is 4. And now add the numbers underneath the square root. And 16 plus 4 is 20, so square root of 20. If you want to find an approximation, use your calculator, and you will get 4.47. So that means the distance from point A to point B is about 4.47 units. Now let's do a Pythagorean theorem problem. Now how do I know I'm going to use the Pythagorean theorem on this problem? Well, look what's given. It's a triangle, and not just any triangle. It is a right triangle, because if you look at the coordinate plane, remember, every x meets a y at a 90 degree angle. And so the way it's plotted, you know it's a 90 degree right triangle. So we know the value of A is 4 and B is 3, but we don't know what C is. What is that hypotenuse? Well, the Pythagorean theorem is A squared plus B squared equals C squared, where A and B are the lengths of legs and C is the hypotenuse. So all we have to do is plug in the values that we know. So we have 4 squared plus 3 squared equals C squared. Well, let's simplify that. 4 squared is 16 and 3 squared is 9, but we can add those numbers. 16 plus 9 will give you 25, but that's the value of C squared. I want to know what the value of C is. Well, to get rid of a square or to cancel off a square, you do the opposite, which is the square root. And whatever we do to one side of an equation, we must do the exact same thing to the other side. So take the square root of both sides. If you do that, the square root of 25 is 5. And the square and square root with the C both cancel off, so you get C. So that distance, that length of that hypotenuse, is 5 units. Let's try that one more time. So here we go, we've got another triangle. So this time we've got the value of A is 5, the value of B is 5, what is C? Well, to figure that out, we've got a right triangle, so it's A squared plus B squared equals C squared, the Pythagorean theorem. Let's plug in the values we know, which are A and B, and they're both 5. So we have 5 squared plus 5 squared equals C squared, and 5 squared is 25. Well, now we just have to add the 25s, and 25 and 25, well, that's going to give you 50. But that's the value of C squared. We want to know the value of C. Well, to get rid or cancel off the square, you do the opposite, which is the square root. So what we do to one side, we must do the exact same thing to the other side. So we're going to take the square root of both sides. And the square root of 50 is about 7.07 units. And that's equal to, well, square and square root with the C also cancel each other out. So we get C is about 7.07. That is the length of that missing side of that right triangle.